For Tula Rashi people, this eclipse happens in the 9th house. Now Rahu assumes the form of Rajata, so there is a Rajata Murti there, it's good. The heavyweights, Jupiter and Saturn, both are Loha Murti, so they become bad there. So this eclipse will give you two things. One is, it is not actually good for your mother. Your mother might actually fall sick, and the reasons could be either cholesterol or it could be dehydration. So take extra care of your mother. Matru Deva Bhava, it's very important. Take extra care of your mother. There will also be some sort of a property related disputes, especially legal problems could be seen after the eclipse, roughly 3 months after the eclipse, and you need to be careful about it. So stay calm and be cautious about what's happening in the environment. If you own a property, make sure that you are alert and aware and you don't succumb to any negative cases that are there. Now as a remedy, here's what I want you to do. During the eclipse, chant Ganesha mantra. Do the japam of Ganesha. It is Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Follow up with one of the two mantras I am going to give you. First one is Om Namah Shivaya. Second one is Om Namo Narayanaya. Any one of these you can do. Japam of one of these two mantras. If you are doing Om Namah Shivaya, then use a Rudraksha mala. If you are doing Om Namo Narayanaya, use a Tulsi mala. Both these mantras, whichever you are choosing, you can do it any as many number of times as possible, but multiples of 108. Now once the eclipse is over, here's what I want you to do. Now this is an annular solar eclipse. That means that this eclipse is going to have its effect for 3 months. So once the eclipse is over, I want you to donate Channa Dal and Black Sesame to the poor and needy. Donate it as many times as possible, daily, alternate day, once a week, once a month, once a fortnight, whatever is comfortable for you. The minimum quantity that you need to donate is going to be 1 fistful. So donate 1 fistful of Channa Dal and Black Sesame to the needy. The second thing I want you to do is to recite Hanuman Chalisa, and recite this every day. Now if you are not able to recite Hanuman Chalisa, at least listen to it every day. The next thing that I want you to do is look in your house, look at the southeast corner and make sure it is free of affliction. And especially we have noticed that when the southeast corner has some sort of an affliction, invariably the legal disputes with regard to property increases. So make sure that you keep the southeast corner free of afflictions.